Hello, I'm Jolene. So today I'm here at Expo. And everybody's watching her, but she's looking at you.
Once a year, I do this workshop called Big Dream Intensive to share with people this five-step process. And here's the thing, regardless of whether you decide to join me or not, I want you to know what this five-step process is, how it works, so that you can decide if you're going to do it yourself or work with me in order to have it implemented together with you.
Over 13 months, not one return phone call. And then the next time we got together, she had my baby. Maybe not the next time, but it makes it better story. 26 phone calls. Did not return my phone call. 26. And I knew every time I made a phone call, I got a little closer. I didn't see it as rejection. I saw it as, hey, I'm getting a little closer to what I want. An entrepreneur takes risk, time and money in order to get more time and money, to improve the quality of their life. If you're not investing time and money, right? Time, tick-tock, and money. Okay, that's what it takes to become an entrepreneur. That's why you don't want to tell people no. By the way, anytime you add no as a customer, you start telling people no. I don't know, I can't tell you, I'm not sure. Money stops because certainty goes down. You understand? You understand what I'm saying? Grant, I don't know, okay? Well, then what happens is money stops because there's a barrier, right? Everything just stops right there. When he said, I don't know what I can do for you, money stops, right or wrong. When you go to buy something, let me think about it. How many of you in the room think about everything? You were brought up to do this. Never make a rash decision, ever, right? Guess what? Money stops. Now you go to work and you try to sell something, and guess what? Your customer's going to tell you, we never make a rash decision. And you're like, I understand. Me either. And money stops. You get it?
Judge you on age, you just need to move on to the next person and figure out which one's not going to judge you on age. And by the way, youngsters, take it from everybody. Who's over 40 here? Raise your hands. Raise it high. Us with our hands up. We lived in a world where 100% of 20-year-olds and 25-year-olds were not listened to. Because technology became big, you guys are way more respected than we were at 25. You're over respected. I mean it. People think, oh, you're a kid, you understand technology. No, you don't. So, the reality is, you've heard a lot of this today. Don't be in the convincing business. Go to who's already convinced. You know what I mean? You got it.
Okay.